In this video, we will be discussing the Monte Carlo tool in Expert Advisor Studio. Now, the greatest way to test the robustness of your strategies is by using the Monte Carlo tool. Its main advantage is that it checks if a strategy is over-optimized. For this purpose, it tweaks certain parts of the history data or the execution of the trades, and it also changes some of the indicator's value. After you alternate your strategy and the data a bit, and you notice that the backtest still shows good results, then it is very likely to be profitable when you trade it live. On the other hand, if the strategy fails after your changes, then you shouldn't use it in a live trading environment since it's over-optimized. In other words, it works well only in specific conditions, and when they change, it no longer performs well. You can find the Monte Carlo tool by selecting a strategy. You can access the Monte Carlo tool by selecting a strategy, and once you have it loaded, you can select the Monte Carlo tab. Now what you'll see is that on the left we have multiple simulations available. Firstly, we have the randomized history data. Now what the randomized history data does is it changes the range on a specific number of bars. Next we have randomized spread. What the randomized spread does is it allows you to choose what value the spread should have. The range is defined in the settings tab. Next we have randomized slippage. Now, slippage is a common thing and it represents a rapid change in price. Sometimes it is just one or two ticks before your broker fills the order and it gets executed. The Monte Carlo tool adds slippage in the opposite direction of your order. So if you go to the settings tab, you can choose the value of the slippage and frequency. Next is the randomly skip positions entry. Now what this will do is we'll simulate some of the problems you may have. For example, your internet connection goes down, something happens on your computer and it freezes or it runs slowly, or your broker might have some technical issues. So it simulates all of those possibilities. Next we have randomly skip position exit, and this is the same just on the exit of a position. Then we have randomly close the position. Now this is not something that happens frequently, but we advise you to stay away from brokers that close your trades for whatever reasons. Next we have strategy variations, and firstly we have the randomized indicator parameters. By default this is set to off. As you can see here, we have selected it to be on, and what happens is when you activate it, the tool changes a certain percentage of the values of the strategy indicators. Of course, this is just for the duration of the test. After all, if you see that the profits decrease drastically or the strategy ends up losing, then you know that it is over-optimized. And lastly, we have randomized backtest starting bar, and this is a good way to test your strategy as well. The worst thing it could show you is that you can blow the whole account if you start the backtest from a different date. So what we're going to do is run the Monte Carlo now, and we're going to leave the settings default, and we're just going to run it with the strategy variations enabled. So we simply click start, and what you'll see is that very quickly it runs through all 20. It has validated 16 of the 20. Now, depending on what your criteria is, you can select whether or not you still want to use the strategy based on the validation of 16 of 20, which is 80%. Once you have run the test, you can go to your confidence table, which is the next tab. And what you'll see is that here you will see the confidence table. Now, the confidence table provides you with statistics for all the tests. The information about the original strategy is in the first row. Then we have a confidence column. Now, the confidence column shows you the chance of having bigger profits in comparison with the net balance value. As you can see, this one goes up to 55%. So there is a 55% confidence that this strategy can provide you with $209 of profit. Next, we have the settings tab. Now, this is where you can set all of the settings for your robustness test. First, we have the count of tests, and this is where you can set how many tests you wanted to perform. Next, we have the count of changed bars. This is the percentage of bars that you change. Next, we have date range, ATR percent. This is the percentage of bars that will change based on the average true range indicator. Then we have the maximum spread in points, and this is the maximum value of the random spread that the tool uses. Then under the execution problems, maximum slippage in points. This is where you would put the maximum value of the slippage. Then we have skip entry probability in percent. This option shows that there is a chance for each entry not to occur, and the default is 2%. Next we have skip exit probability, and respectively, EA Studio offers the same option for the exits as well. The default probability for a trade not to have an exit is again 2%. Then close position probability. This is where the tool goes through each bar to check the likelihood of a trade not closing. Next, we have strategy variations. The first is indicator change probability. This shows you how many of the indicator's values can change. The default value here is 20%. Next is indicator max change percent. This option shows the possible difference between the original value and the changed value. Then we have the minimum deviation range. This feature is suitable for indicators with low values because small changes in them won't have much an effect. Also here, the default value is 20 steps. And lastly, we have the reset button, which just resets all of the values to default should they have changed. Lastly, we have the validation tab. Now here you can set certain validation criteria. When you operate either the reactor or the validator, you can see that the Monte Carlo tool is active in the robustness testing section. The validator test option under the Monte Carlo validation settings works similarly as the general acceptance criteria in the collections page. When you click on the add validation criteria button, you are able to add multiple parameters such as the minimum count of trades, maximum equity drawdown in percent, or minimum net profit, and many others. And here you can add the validation criteria that you want your Monte Carlo to use. You have many options available that you can add, remove, or edit.